Hi, this is Judy from Handcrafted Greetings. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make a pyramid card using My Memories Suite 4. The first thing you'll need to do is create an 8.5 by 11 inch album. So click Design Your Own, choose Portrait, choose 8.5 by 11, click OK. And then remove the margin guides. You do that by clicking View Guides, Trim Area. And then open the photo control panel, and that's this one right here, and add a photo box. Just click on it and it will be added to your page. Right click the photo box and open the object information box. Deselect keep proportions and enter a measurement in that's proportionally will fit the image that you're going to make layers of. So mine is 5.45. And then once you've done that, just click the X and make a copy of that and paste it. Do a right click, open object information, and shrink this one. Leave the key proportions checked this time. I'm going to make mine 3.25. Then close it. So now I've got two boxes, one slightly smaller than the other. I'm going to make a copy of this smaller box, paste it, right click, object information. This one I'm going to make 2.5 inches. And then the last one I'm going to make 1.75 inch. Now, if you have something in your image, like I do that with the letters that I had stand out, then I'm going to want to create a box for those letters as well. So I'll just add a box, and I'm just going to use the handles, these little tabs, to resize it. But I need to load the picture so I can see what I need to resize it to. So I'm going to move all of these, and you can select them by holding down on your shift key and clicking. I'm going to move the smaller boxes off of the big one. Oops, I missed one. And I'm going to add my photo. And I want this to be about the same size as Joy, those letters. So I'm going to put that on there, make sure I've got it completely covered, and then click on this photo back here and remove it. Now I'm going to select both the little box for the lettering and the box background box. Select both of those and then go to Arrange and click Group. And then I'm going to add my, I'm going to drop my photo on there again. And then ungroup. What this does is now I've got a perfectly sized lettering. Now I'm going to need to do the same thing with these layers. So first I'm going to remove the picture. And I need to have these all lined up. Stacked centered both vertically and horizontally. So I want to select them all, and you can do that by you do a click and a drag, and you just drag over so that your selection box is touching each one. So now they're all selected. Click Arrange, Align, Middle, Arrange, Align, Center, and that stacks them all up. Now that I've got them all stacked, I'm going to click Arrange, Group, And it doesn't matter really what order they're stacked in. This one, the big one's on top, but that doesn't matter. Now I'm going to grab my picture again and add it. And then arrange and ungroup. And you can see that now I have multiple layers. So I wanted to add a border around these three smaller layers so they match the top one and you can tell the layers apart. So again, I'm going to just drag so that all three of those are selected. And I want to add a mat, so click mat. And I don't want a white mat. I'm going to change the mat. And I want to choose a color that's going to match the picture. So I'm going to use the picker. And what this does is it brings up a small image of what you have on your page. And you can just hover over a color that you want and click it. Click OK. And it's made that mat. I don't want my mat to be 4 pixels wide. I want it to be 3. So I'm just going to drag that down. You can make it real fat or you can make it real thin. 3 pixels is about where I want mine. Do that, click OK, and there a mat has been added to each one. Now all I have to do is arrange these on the page so that they're not overlapping. So there we go. And then I can print it. So I want to, if you've never exported, I'll show you how to do that. You click on Share Album, click Export Pages. Yes, I do want to save. So I'm going to save this as Christmas card. And it takes a little while there. And then I want to save this as a PDF. Click Finish. And this will create a PDF. And then I just need to go out and open it. And here's the folder that it created. And there's the PDF. And from here, all I have to do is print it, cut out the layers, and then assemble them on the card. There's the PDF that it created there. And that's all there is to it. Very simple.